I come from an immigrant family. I was born in Hackney, and both halves at different times come from Poland. My mother's family in the 1890s, and my father arrived by way of Germany, and thank goodness only staying there for a year, in about 1919. And my father had left school at 14. And my mother, I suppose because poor family in Britain would also leave school at 14 or maybe 15 in those days, the same. And when he'd, they were very, very poor initially. And we lived in a flat above a shop in Commercial Road, now demolished because I must try to look for it. It's in a roundabout or something, or traffic thing. And then when they, rather classical immigrant fashion, he'd made enough money to go slightly more upmarket. We moved then to Willesden, Brondesbury, Cricklewood, until the war, when the children were evacuated and all broke up in various directions and bombing and this sort of stuff. And my father was a very, well, one thing, he was an extraordinarily hardworking chap. And although he had no education, he was a terribly searching chap. When he had more time, he was an avid reader, mostly history and politics. And he was, you know, as I realised later, perhaps a bit too late, an interesting bloke to talk to. But as I got older, we talked more together. And, you know, he was, I now realise, quite a one-off, you know. He was an unusual chap, and he had this burning interest. He felt he wasn't the least bit vain. The question of university degrees he couldn't have cared less about. It was absolutely irrelevant to him. But he felt the lack of an educational structure on which his interest would hang. Mm. I mean, he didn't need it actually, but he felt it. And as he got older, of course, you know, the old age things are history and gardening. I don't think he did much gardening, but history is the great old age activity. And he got into that in a big way.
People often seem to be, to use a word, proud about their parents or about their parents for children. Did you feel he admired your work or understood your
yes.
work?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, they were very, very proud. Mm. And I think one was, as a young, brash person, not exactly dismissive, but you didn't focus enough on these old people's lives. And that's why my wife, Joan, is very, very keen on people of my age writing down or recording their experience. Because you know you love your and know your grandchildren, and then you die off, and then the grandchild, then an adult, says, yeah, I remember that funny old boy. What did he do with himself? Mm. What life did he lead? Mm. And I don't know. I know something, but not all that much about the previous. Mm. I know my father's and mother's life, of course. And my mother came from a big family and seven children. Her father died very young, and she was the middle of them. Yeah, I do think older people should relate to what has their experiences, especially people who've either lived through or been part of the wars and the great things. I mean, you know, Tolstoy was quite wrong. All families are interesting, not just the unhappy ones.